Here we go, buddy. Woohoo! Alright. Hey, what's up, guys?
Not much.
Hey, hey, hey.
Not much.
Alrighty. I am gonna grab a case. We got harvesting to do.
Yep, I took the New Holland, so you didn't have to worry about it.
Nice, nice. Holy buckets. And we do have, what was I gonna say? We have a auger wagon. So if somebody wants to park like a double, and
we got a sim right now.
Yeah, we can either use the semi or you can park the semi and use an auger wagon, whichever whoever does that job prefers. I never care because in real life they do them both around here anyway. Always get people.
I'll play with this in a little bit.
Yeah. Some people always say you gotta use an auger wagon, never take the semi in the field. Well, they do it here all the time.
I
know, you gonna drive it, buddy? Uh oh, I'm heading up to a cornfield with a. What? Which fields? Wait.
15.
11.
We're going to 11.
Or 15.
Yeah, I just took the longer way around.
Yeah, I was.
Take out the signs
on
the
way. Oh my goodness! I was following you out, and then I was like, "Wait a minute, we got corn over here." I know there's so much crops in here.
And our sheep.
Oh my god! Got the triple! Got the triple going! Oh, this is gonna be a beast. You look like a snake slithering through the map, ASIM.
Gonna wait until I get up here.
Yeah, I guess I took the long way around, but I don't have to pay for the signs out of my paychecks. I'm not the one that ran them all over. Oh, be nice to me now, Ping. Be nice to me. Boy, as soon as you hit that field. I hope I'm farting the straw out here. Nope. There we go. Look at that, buddy. Now we're cruising. Austin is in training right now. He's in observation mode. That's the word. Oh, we gotta. Jackson says, teach him to blame Lee. Oh, don't worry, he will. We'll definitely be teaching him to blame Lee. You see this guy over here? Anything bad? He did it.
Now we're gonna square it out, or we're gonna just go back and forth.
We'll go around and corner, or you know what I mean. You want to do that? Because then our pipes are always on the outside.
Yep.
Except we're kind of. Yeah. Guess that'll work. You think, bud? I know! Lee, I'm gonna let you go in front of me. That way we can see everybody.
Hey.
I'm gonna back up. I'll back up out of your way.
I'm at 82%.
I got you, Lee.
Cheesy people are saying to use the auger wagon, please.
Oh, alright. I'll get it here in just a second.
You'll still probably... You'll want to leave the truck out here, though. Yeah, it's true, Sam. Take the semi into the field, it ruins the compaction of the field, and the semi can get stuck, yeah. I normally around here see them take the semis into the field. It's very rare to see them, you know, the ones that do the fields right around us, including our field. They'll always usually take the semi right out there. They don't normally use auger wagon. I can't remember the last time I saw an auger wagon being used, however, I do know that they are obviously commonly used. For the same reason that Sam had said. It all depends too on the conditions of the field. If it's really wet. Jason, you might have to.
What?
It's gonna get a little tricky if he uses the auger wagon though. Just because it's going to be a lot of running back and forth. Right now, I'm stopped. And it's going to become really nightmarish if you guys get... If we get too spread apart for ASIM, he'll be driving all over the field.
I'll stop right at the corner up here. That'll be almost at 100.
You want to square off this field?
Yeah, we'll square it off, and then we'll do the second part after that.
Alright. Go get the auger wagon here for you guys.
Lee, you should hit the middle one that way, Brandon, to get to the last one.
He just got empty.
Okay.
I can pull up.
I'm empty, yeah. Now we're just gonna square off this little lip over here, right? We're not gonna go straight across towards the farm.
We're gonna go straight across towards the farm, and then just
I would head straight up and just chunk this little piece off, because when you go to windrow it, it's a lot easier. That's a long chunk right there. You know what I mean?
Whatever you want to do.
It makes it easier when you row it too, because this piece that we're doing right here is a little piece. We're not very synchronized today. Oh. Blaming Lee on that one. Blame Lee!
Are we gonna have an Aussie pop in maybe today?
I don't know.
So where is this auger wagon?
Somewhere.
It might make it really difficult for you to use it, because it's gonna fill up so quick. You're gonna be running around back and forth. You almost kind of have to use the semi and just keep hammering on each one of us. It's a busy
nice
and
there, Jason.
Yeah, sorry, I've been drinking a little bit today. It's snowing out, so I have that reason to do it.
Yeah,
it's
we're
day of spring and it's snowing.
Oh my goodness. It's still St. Patty's Day out there. Apparently. Holy crap, dude. We went sideways across the field.
It's close enough.
Look at all those trucks. I know. Combine. Man, these things take forever to empty. A truck's gonna be working when it gets full. Nameless Sheep, thank you so much for the follow. We also have Phobias and Epic Aereo, and anybody else that I may have forgotten, thank you for the follow. Baldino, thank you for the follow as well. Blue Radio, thank you. Blue Paw Radio, rather. Sorry. Blue Paw. Blue Paw Radio. What map is this? It's Westbridge Hills. What's coming out the back straw? And we're harvesting wheat.
Not gonna hold the train up too long emptying.
Ah! Go fart and straw out. This server is also played in hard mode. Crop withering on, 24/7 dedicated, so crops are always set to slow. 2 days to get crops from the time you plant till the time they're ready to harvest, and you got 1 day to get them out or they wither. AJ said he can't wait for the kids to start blaming Lee for everything, even around the house. Yeah, my kids would be running around. Who brought all this mud in? Blame Lee! Oh my god.
Lee, I'll let you go down.
My wife's gonna be getting after Aiden for something, and he'll be like, Lee did it! Did I do Pleasant Valley yet? Yes. But we need to start being a little nicer to Lee or he's gonna rage quit.
Ooh, almost time that quit.
Just hammering out the crops. Uh-oh. Just froze a little bit. What are you doing? What are you doing?
180.
Oh my god, right into me. Tore the pipe off my deal here. If you sit still, ASIM, I'll empty. We'll all empty. Everybody will get their pipe in the,
double pipe in one trailer.
Yep. I bet that number is going up pretty quick there, ASIM.
Yes, it is.
All right.
Lee.
I'm gonna get this little spot right here. I missed. I couldn't grab the whole thing.
Holy buckets of lag, a little bit.
I mean, you just came from Texas up to New York right now.
Yeah, we're in the Pleasant Valley's right now in Dallas, Texas. We might move that, though. And this one is in New York City. Got a little bit better ping here, but... Whoops.
I got great ping here.
Yeah.
Running in the 20s.
That's how I am on Bjarnholm.
Might be a little sideways on this one. I'm just trying to catch the stuff I missed.
Yeah, well, I left a gap on mine. I'm trying to straighten it out.
Yeah, I had a gap.
Is there a specific version of the game for dedicated server? It's 1.2. That's their last major update, if I'm not mistaken. What do you think, bud? You want to see inside? Look at that road train. That's like an Aussie road train.
No brakes.
Yeah, you're definitely not gonna have brakes.
That's going downhill.
Yeah, I think we almost smoked them.
That's a nice dent that we put with one pass.
Field 9 is
the bug. Oh, that's going to be awesome with four of these, because we're still one short on our harvesters. We're one short on, we're going to get one more New Holland. Damn it.
You gotta get the ballet coordinated.
Oh my god. We're like a bunch of 90-year-old ladies in the synchronized swimming. This is terrible.
Well, I'm gonna get out of here.
It's like synchronized swimming day at the nursing home.
Yeah.
case him. I'm at 93%.
Lee just fell off his walker.
Yeah, we're gonna have to let Jason head a little bit here so I can get you into the single trailer.
Let Austin drive. Yeah, he doesn't do much. He kind of likes to... He likes to just watch.
Alright, I'm gonna stop here. Let the star fart out. I'm gonna loop around.
Is the pipe thing... Which approved? Always blame Lee. Is there a specific version on the game for dedicated server? Oh, we already answered that one. Yeah, it's 1.2. Who do we got here? We've got King. King and TrollGirl129, thank you so much for the follows. You driving? We've got to wait. We're all full. We're gonna get full. Gotta get all emptied. That thing is getting tricky to drive, isn't it, ASIM?
Very much so.
Blame Lee for the lag. No, the lag is, it starts for me this time of day about... starts getting worse, but we're also doing a lot on the server at one time. The bigger the equipment, the more communication that has to happen between the players and the server. Like, you're removing crops or you're planting crops. And then the fact that we've got three really big pieces of equipment going all at once.
On the same field.
On the same field. That hurts a little bit, but it's really not that bad. I mean, I've seen a heck of a lot worse. Not that bad at all. I'm not even to the other end yet, guys. I'm just now starting to turn around to make my approach down like you guys are. Alright, buddy, here we go. Yeah, he might do better than Aiden driving the semi next to the combine. He might. They're so innocent when they're like 3-4 years old, like they just pretty much do whatever and they, you know, they don't have their own ideas about what they want to do yet. Aiden's gotten a lot more difficult to do farming with the older he gets. Kind of wants to do his own thing. And that usually is not the right thing that we need to do. Gonna go? Thanks for helping, buddy. Helping. Alright, he's all farmed out.
Hey, Sam, head to the pull other it? Side. You can unload me.
You have the door open?
The other downside.
Knock on the door. Hold on 1 second. Alright, you had to go see Mama. Who is in my lap? That's my second oldest, Austin. Does my wife play sometimes? She has, she played 2011 a lot. Not a lot, but more with me than probably any, because we didn't have kids so much. Well, Aiden, but he was, when he'd go to, like, go to bed at night, she would jump on and help me. That was long before YouTube and having other friends that played, and I would need to do corn, like, chaff the corn, and it was really hard to do, like, when you chaff at one end of the field and you had all your crops, to turn around and have to run that back to the main farm or the biogas or whatever, you know, once that biogas mod, because that wasn't part of vanilla 2011. Biogas was a mod that you had to purchase. And, she used to come in and help me run a truck. We'd put a helper on the big X1100 and I'd run a truck and she'd run a truck. By the time she was full, I'd be back, and then I'd get full, I'd go empty, she'd be back, and we'd hammer out a field that way. But she does want to get more involved. It's just that she's very, very busy, you know, with the children right now. Got our youngest, Ashton. He's really dependent on her because, you know, he's not even a year old yet, so... she'll definitely get in more probably on the Minecraft side of things with us. So... Nick, 10,000, what's happening? Watching the streamer Aiden helped you. Oh man, I was on Wednesday night. Yeah, Wednesday night was, but I mean, I was kind of expecting that. But he's been in this kick lately where all he wants to do is Minecraft. He says he wants to play other games, but I think he says it just because he knows that that's what we do. But he's five. I mean, his attention span is very short with a lot of things. You know, he has his things that he really likes, and that's what he wants to do. And he wants to play Minecraft, and he wants to live stream Minecraft. That's all. And we finally did last night play Minecraft in the server, and he was so excited. He was just losing it. Sorry to hear about that, farmers. All right, guys. Sorry, I had to mute for a minute there. Boy, that field went quick.
We are in the back trailer only now.
Okay. Let him pass A7 and pulling, and I'm at 90%.
Oh, you're not full yet. I thought you were full and I was pulling up behind you to empty while I was waiting, but... Alright.
I'm at 90.
Sounds good.
Now I'm gonna have to go over. I'm full. Catch up to you.
I am driving straight across the field, Lee. I'm not sure. Like, I'm cutting into your territory here big time. Now I'm going
I'll
angled.
I'll clean up your mess.
Well, I'm.
You always do, Lee.
Unbelievable. I should have waited, but. Trying to see how much we can hammer out today. Alright. It's cutting really into your territory. I'm looking at the lines in the map, and I was following those lines, but hell, it was cutting really bad in here. I imagine those brakes are getting pretty warm.
Hey, you can always do a test on the man truck, too.
Oh my god. That thing would not work. Dan514, thank you, and Farm Sim, thank you so much for the follow. Fabby, thank you so much for the follow as well.
I don't know, I had the man truck on two rivers, and I had a triple behind it.
Alright, Asim, I should be good. I'll just roll with me here. I almost is emptied out, but I just don't want to be in Lee's way when he comes through. There we go. Appreciate that.
No problem.
We're gonna get.
Make it to the end of the row.
We're gonna nearly get 300,000 out of that.
I'm stuck.
Are you stuck? Oh, I can't do it.
I'm full down here.
That is why Westbridge is making so much money. These fields are huge, and you plant, you put in so much crop. Now if we had more people, we could have somebody raking and somebody picking up.
We gotta leave some for Husky to do later.
Set a record. Sharp Gamer, how's it going? Oh, you forgot your account name. Marcus Mago, how's it going? Pig Hunter, how you doing? And Killer 1931, what's up, brah? Yeah, it's never fun having a puppy pass away. Uh-oh. See what yield you get off this entire field. Yeah, we got some viewers that are interested to see what yield we get off of our field here. I am too. It's obviously going to be pretty close to 300,000. Our trailer holds 100,000, and there's two of them that are full. Jason, you're all empty?
I'm all empty.
Alright, I will go empty, and Lee will be coming up behind.
I'm going to go switch out the header now. So we got a bunch of corn planted. Wonder how the biogas is, if it's full or not.
You know, I can't remember. I was over there 2 days ago, and there was stuff in there. All right, Lee, now you get to dump. Asim, when he gets done, just let us know.
Ooh.
Where you're at.
And your husky's jumping in.
Oh, come on now.
Oh, synchronizing sim! Game that always comes for free. Every copy of Farming 15. Give me a second here. Gots to do this. Make a quick change. While we're synchronizing. While we're synchronizing. Alright.
There we go.
There we go. There we go. Dragon X137, thank you so much for the follow. Hey, Husky Farmer in the house. Gordon Hathaway, thank you so much for the follow. I don't think I'm going to fit in here.
Final total, 277,082.
278,000. I just took out the barn. That didn't work. Got all these nice wide places to drive, and I had to go to the one that was not right. I got to get ahead of Lee. That's all I care. Oh.
I'm resetting that corn cutter, I think.
Is there one that's yellow? What happened? You can't pick it up?
Nope, too far up against the wall.
Alright, let me drop this one. Holy buckets. Caught on the ridge. My track actually got caught on the ridge of the thing and it kept me from turning. Just about got to fold that pipe in. That's part of the problems. Pipe sticks out.
Yeah, I mean, you just smashed my window when you turned around with it.
I did.
Yeah.
Oh, got on a real farm, our repair bills would be outrageous. There'd be so many farm accidents.
I'll let you go in.
The auger wagon's in that center shed.
The auger, yeah. He'd be, especially now when we switch to corn, he'll never be able to keep up with an auger wagon. We'd need, well, Husky's in here, but now with Husky and with the semi rolling close, it would work.
Buddy disconnected from their channel.
Oh, well, fine then. What are we doing first? Are we going to do 18? Which
that's
one is
in corn?
15 is too. Unless if that's some really strange new breed of grass that we're growing.
Yeah, I guess it is.
I'm just looking to see here which one is getting dinkered the most. And we got two of them there. Whoops.
There we go.
Can you guys hear me now?
Yep, we hear you. Yeah.
Okay.
18 and 15 both need to be taken out. They're about to go bad. You want to run an auger wagon there, Husky?
That's what I was going to do. I was just going to go run over and grab the stagger and put that up to the auger wagon.
Very nice. You end up getting it out.
Oh yeah, I reset it. I'll wait until everyone's in position.
Are you not going to field 18 right
yeah.
now?
Yeah, we're on 18.
Yeah. It's Jessica. I'm just going to park tractor by the field here, and then I got to get off.
Okay, yeah. Joined late. What's been happening? We are... Oh, Magoo. Marcus Magoo. We're just doing Westbridge. We did Pleasant Valley, but you didn't miss a thing, because we'll be putting the whole deal on YouTube. It'll be on YouTube by tomorrow sometime. Alright, here we go. Thank you so much to Dragon. We got Jordan, LP, Aaron, and Weg44. Thank you so much for those follows. We appreciate all of them. Very much so. Oh, gotta love the email, that's right. Uh-oh, we're going crooked here. Sorry about that, Lee, I got reading the chat and went crooked on ya.
Nathan, if you want to park it at, like, that intersection up ahead, right there, so it's about in the middle, that usually works good.
You're gonna have a busy job there, Husky.
I know.
It was an honor, gents. I'll see you later.
Alright, thank you, ASIM. Take care.
Talk to you later.
See ya.
Oh, where'd the triple?
Might have lost one. That might be the other setup. Did we always have a triple, or did you just put a triple in?
I put a triple in last week.
Really?
Yeah.
Alright, Husky, I'm empty. Go tend to the other guys. Especially Lee.
Yeah, Lee would probably need it.
Well, we'll definitely... Last time I did this field of corn, I... Got about 350,000 liters out of it, so.
Yeah. It'll go through a bunch. It'll go through a bunch. Wouldn't be the first time. Jason is driving the New Holland, yes. Oh yeah, Untry Boy, that would be good, you know, with the couple people there. ASIM had to get taken off, so. Is there mods on this server? Yeah, this server is heavily modded. And I wouldn't say heavily, it's there's a lot of mods on. This is the server that we run all of our mods. Any mod that we use will be on Westbridge. Even Bjornholm, I don't put quite as many mods, but obviously that tractor, that auger wagon, those are both mods. Trucks, the map itself, I edited that. I guess that'd be considered a mod. A lot of things, a lot of tools and equipment, but these combines, these are all vanilla. These are all vanilla. The headers is vanilla. We're getting a little bit of lag, but we're harvesting, and that is the time that you'll send a lot of stuff back and forth to the server, so... I've also got the quality of the live stream up a little bit higher than I normally do, just pushing it today. But it's well enough, it's well enough. We just gotta get through this summer and we'll be getting some nice internet when we get into the new house. Hopefully that'll be right around September, October, no later than November. So, we gotta make do with what we got for right now. And then things will really be getting sweet. Bjornholm is a real private server. It's where all the chore logs happen. There's nobody that really goes in there. It's really basically just Lee and myself. Our admins, it's kind of our admin server. However, none of them really play on there. Jason will pop in there every once in a great while. He was in there for about an hour, about 2 weeks ago. Probably, other than Lee and myself, it's probably been maybe about an hour a month that somebody else will pop in there. Evil popped in about 2 months ago for maybe an hour. I think Ross was in there on that day. There's really nobody they're all welcome to play in there. They just choose to play Pleasant Valley or Westbridge, but that's a map that it's locked up pretty tight, and it's controlled because that's a business server for me, because that is where the chore logs happen. So we keep things a little bit tighter over there on the Bjornholm. But we do open our Pleasant Valley every once in a while. That was open yesterday. Have we broke ground on the new house yet? Not yet. We haven't even found a lot. We're still shopping for dirt. And now that the snow's melted, we can see the dirt. We're going to go dirt shopping. We're going to go lot shopping next month. We're waiting to get a few things cleared up, though, on the bank side of things. With the finances and everything before we go and get you gotta get a pre-approval letter from the bank, so you know have something on paper to know, like, yes, this is gonna happen. And we're waiting to get our taxes back to use some of those funds for some of that stuff. So next month we're gonna be heavy on the dirt shopping. That's what I call it. It's shopping for a lot, place to put the house. And then we will be breaking ground on it, hopefully, hopefully by June. Just thinking, it takes 3 months for them to build, so we're going to start dirt shopping next month, but I think really in May is when we're going to try to secure a lot. But we got to get bank stuff done. So, it's a big process. It's going to be a lot of work. It's going to require a lot of time. Where we're going is an hour and 40 minutes away in central Wisconsin. And it's going to be a lot of time I'm going to have to take off this summer. Because if we go to build a house, that's something that I plan to live in until I'm old. And I'm not really full. I'll just empty while I'm waiting. Go ahead.
Yeah, so do I.
Lee, are you full or?
No, I'm empty.
Okay, I was just emptying, so I'll wait for you to nail that roll. Thank you, sir. But yeah, we'll be doing that here soon. I'll be taking a lot of pictures. I'll be doing a lot of videos, because unfortunately it's going to pull me away from the games. And I think it'd be fun to make some videos of the progress. I'm going to be out there at least twice a week probably. It's going to be a lot of driving. But I do not want to just like, hey, build me a house and then call me when it's done. Because, man, oh man, you got to stay on top of that. Got to stay on top of what's going on. Make sure things are getting done right. You got to be very involved, or else you might have a horror story. And this is the first time that we've built a house, had one built for us. Our last house was also brand new, but it was 2 weeks from being completed. So we kind of walked in and said, hey, I like the I like the paint and the wall colors and all that, and yeah, it's a nice house, we'll take it, kind of a thing. So, and there was things that I found out afterwards that I didn't like so much, so I want to get a lot more involved with this one. So, ooh, it's going to be a busy summer. What mod site that I use, unfortunately, is too many to list. We have FSUK and the main farm sim website are the ones that I like the most, but I don't actually go out and get a lot of these mods. Other people are doing it and saying, hey, check this out, let's put this in the server, and we do it. But they're using LS15, LS2015, Mod Hub, Mod This, Mod That, LS This, Farm Sim That. It's just a ton of websites. Really, when people ask what mod site do you use, the best thing I can tell you, Google.com. Google.com, type in FarmSim15, whatever you're looking for, John Deere, Case, need a forage wagon, need this, need that, see where it takes you, look at the reviews, download it, try it, if it's broken, fix it, like we do, or not at all. That's basically what we do. We don't really have a mod site that we use. American Iron Modding is another one that Husky belongs to, and some of the mods come from over there. Just kind of all over the place, and a lot of the mods we get, we don't like exactly certain things, we fix them and edit them, but pretty much what we've been doing. It's unfortunate that we have to even use mods. I wish farming as a game had a lot more stuff, but I'm not really a big fan of the mods, but you know, you kind of have to be if you play this game, because you need them. You need them to get certain things done. Deer Hunter, what's happening? Sharp Gamer, what's happening? What city do you live? Best... Whoa. Thought I was missing. Best thing I can tell you is you can use anything in the central time zone. You could use Minneapolis, you could use Chicago on your world clock. Houston, same time zone. Nashville, Memphis, central time zone, US. But probably Chicago. When you look at central time zone, Chicago is a city that, you know, because it's the biggest city in that time zone. But I am not, I'm about 6 hours away from Chicago, so no, I do not live in Chicago. I just have to keep that information private because of the, you know, getting swatted and everything else. It's very bad. When we get moved to the new city, though, you'll know what city I'm living in. Right now, there's about five buildings in a frickin' 100-mile square radius around me. And that's an exaggeration, but that's what it feels like. I don't tell anybody where I live because it'd be pretty easy to find out which house is mine. It'd be a guess out of about a few. So we're really out in the middle of nowhere, and it sucks out here big time. I hate it. But where we're going is a metropolitan area of about 100,000 people, so we'll pretty much blend right in. I'm going to get a P.O. box set up. I've had people saying, hey, I want to send you this, I want to send you that. Don't have a P.O. box, can't give out my address. Very bad what happens to people on Twitch when they give out their address. They get the police busting their doors down and everything else. There's a lot of pranks that get played. It's very dangerous. It's very illegal. But it's something that is highly advised on Twitch side of things, so you never ever give out your address. So apologize, I can't let that be known, but we'll get a P.O. box set up later on in the year once we get relocated. Then I can correspond with people and they can all that sort of thing. Our post office here is so ridiculous that some days they'll be close because the lady that runs it just won't show up, or she's like tired and doesn't want to work, and the post office just won't be open. I've gone up there to mail a letter at like, you know, 11:30 in the afternoon, and there'll be a sign up on the window saying the post office is closed because of a lunch break. What? Oh my god, that is just, you know, you live out in the middle of freaking nowhere when that happens. Oh my god, it's just it's pathetic. Just pathetic. It's like, seriously? This lady's like 70 years old and she's a little hard getting around, we'll just say that. And they're really bad here too. When I lived down in Tennessee, I had the UPS, FedEx, and the post guy would come up to my house every day because we were running the computer business that had so many packages and parts and everything else that would come to the house. Thank you so much, Carlos, Cutter, Hockey, Thomas, Trucker. Thank you for those follows and anybody else that I may have missed. Appreciate all of them big time. And so anyway, our postmaster would come up to the guy that the mail delivery dude would come right up to the door and say, "Hey, what's happening?" And he would see Aiden, and you know, and if Aiden got like a book or something in the mail from the reading program, like he would get out, even though he didn't have to, he could put it in the mailbox. He would get out, come up to the door, ring the doorbell, and hand Aiden his book. Like, "Here you go, you got a book," you know, and it was, I mean, he didn't have to. He could have just shoved it in the mailbox and went on his way. Up here, my mailbox got taken down by the plow truck or something, and I ordered a garage door opener off of Amazon. Those lazy buggers wouldn't even get out and come up to the frickin' house and drop it on the doorstep. There was no mailbox, so they just kept going. They went back and they frickin' stuck a label on it to go ahead and ship it back to sender, as there was no mail receptacle to put it in. Like, you son of a, you know, I went down there and reamed on that lady and said, you know, the hell, you know, cut a guy a break. I'll get the mailbox put back out there, but don't go and ship my mailbox or my mail back because of that. I hate living out here. I really do. It's probably the worst place I've ever lived in my life. And it's nice because I can step out my back door and just start shooting my guns in every direction almost, but I don't ever shoot. I just never take the time to go out and shoot. I got another fox squirrel that's been hanging around my garage. I saw him 2 days ago, and I've been meaning to go out there at the 12 gauge and take care of him. Or the 22. I should use my 22, but I just haven't gotten around to it, you know. And I enjoy that. I go out there and you know, shoot some. I always kill the fox squirrels because they get into the garage and make a mess. The gray squirrels, I never bother them. They never bother me. They pretty much stick to the trees and stay away from my sheds and stuff. But the damn fox squirrels, the red squirrel, they get to making a mess. I usually, whenever I see them, I don't care what time of the year it is, they die.
They're just dragging everything down.
How are you gonna have enough money anyway?
What? Just having some story times.
Alright, well, we're just gonna go to the other side.
Yeah, that's what I've been doing. Yes, we are moving. Hey, BFD, what's happening, buddy? Welcome.
Alrighty guys, I have got to jump off a little bit.
Alright.
Shovel a little bit, so.
I do not wish to be you, buddy.
So I'm gonna finish what I can on this row and then hop on off.
Sounds good. Don't throw out your back or blow a lung out there now.
I won't.
good exercise, though. I'm so glad that we're not getting that, I have to say. I'm sure we're not done yet, though.
Well, I know, I've been working. I didn't work really today. I went to the shop and did a bunch of stuff, but other than that, yeah, I worked all week this week. Pretty much plan on starting up full bore next week.
With the landscaping?
Yeah. 5 weeks ahead of last year.
5 weeks, oh, I know. Yep. It's good. It's good, too.
It's halfway through March. Third week of March, and last year we started fourth week of April.
God. Yeah, last year we were getting snow right in the middle.
Yep.
And the...
Then it turned into a raid monsoon after that.
Oh my god, yeah. Just rained and rained, like, never let up. Thank you, SeaKing0906, for the follow. Freedom Fighter, thank you for the follow as well. Hopefully it's a little bit drier out this year.
Yeah.
I just remember how much they said that this was supposed to be a really bad winter.
Yep. Supposed to be a very snowy. They said it wasn't going to be as cold, but it said it was going to be a very snowy winter. I think at the most, what did we have, like 4 inches on the ground at the most at one time?
Yeah.
I mean, it was like...
It was laughable.
There was maybe a week of time for the snowmobilers to actually snowmobile. Maybe a week, and that wasn't all at one time. It was maybe like 3 days here, and then you got another 3 days over here, and that was about it.
Yeah, but take a look at Boston. They got, what, 108 inches this year?
Did they really?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I wonder if people do a lot of snowmobiling out there. You would think so.
I don't think in the city.
Not in the city, but I'm talking about in Massachusetts, you know? You don't think of that as being a big snowmobile area, but with that much snow, my God.
Well, it's the first time they hit 100 inches.
Really? Oh, yeah, we didn't get any winter here, really. I mean, it rarely even didn't get cold. Just hammering on this field.
I thought you'd make it up to me there, but I guess not.
Man, this field, yeah, we planted this last time. Now harvesting it. Wow.
I got harvested. I harvested it once in between.
Oh, man. Yeah, we're gonna lose our crops here. We sent all the snow there. Yeah, I think it did. I think it failed to fall on the rest of the country and went out there.
All right, I guess.
All right. Thank you.
Later, Jason.
We should be good till about 7 o'clock, Brandon, on these before they wither.
Okay.
Give it on a 24-hour, because it was after 7 when I started planting on Wednesday. No, it would have been on Tuesday.
I just got my pipe stuck on your pipe. Never cross the swords. Oh, that's not right. Come on! Oh, there we go. It looks like a slideshow. That's definitely on your end. Definitely make sure you're utilizing the sourcing options at the bottom of the video. Definitely, definitely. That's why we got the old sourcing now. Adjust it down to medium, low, or mobile, depending on your capabilities. Because we haven't dropped a single frame yet. hammering it out. What do you like about this game? Oh, I like pretty much what we're doing right now. The multiplayer aspects of it are very enjoyable. That is where I have the most fun. I'm gonna make one quick change here as we're waiting on Lee. Thank you to Michael and Cooper Hill. Thank you so much for the follows. I do appreciate that very much. Freedom, if I forgot you, and MJ Hunter, thank you for the follow. Where are you dumping this corn? In the silo? Or bio? Okay.
I can't dump corn in bio.
Huh?
The chaff
yeah.
In order to bring it to bio.
Right, that's right.
I haven't dumped any of it yet, so we can get a...
Is the biogas, is it pretty full? Are the silos full over there? I was gonna ask.
We've still got one that's completely full with about the same as where we were last week, I'd say. Maybe about a couple hundred thousand liters less, but when each one holds 600,000,
wow.
It takes a while to make a dent.
Did you see the greenhouses we dropped in?
Oh, yeah.
Those work so slick. A placeable helper mod is like to die for if you have OCD and you like things looking straight. It is so nice.
Especially with the semi trailer, the water trailer.
Oh.
Nice, and you can
all you do is put
on.
That's what I did. I set the cruise to like 3 miles an hour and I just went down and hammered them all.
Yep.
Works out so nice. That's what I planned to do today. Well, that was when they were completely empty.
Yep.
Which they should be...
It was like 5, 9 million.
They should be getting pretty empty now, aren't they?
I filled them last night, I think.
I was letting them run down so I could show them off today on filling them and how nice that process works. It really is... Nice to have such an open area, flat area in the map to place them. That's something Giants should think a little bit more about with their maps. They should make more flat areas. As people that don't edit maps, you know, are kind of screwed. They can't do stuff like that without taking up valuable field space, and that's not even flat. And it doesn't look right when you plop them out in the middle of a dirt field.
Oh, yeah.
They should have more gravel flat areas put into the maps. Or pavement. I think we went with asphalt on this one. I kind of did like a broken, dirty asphalt. Did asphalt and then, you know, a lot of mud and dirt on it. Make it look like it's been driven on a whole lot. All right, Sparky, thanks so much for coming by. Appreciate that, dude. Farming real life. I was born on a dairy farm in Wisconsin, but by the time I was about 8 years old, that was all done with. We did some very, very, very small little crop farming stuff. We do have a handful of old tractors and equipment. And I don't get much involved with it, but my dad still puts in about 20, 30 acres of corn that we use just for feeding deer. Well... the legal way, because now you can't feed them because of the chronic wasting. So we grow corn and we just leave it. And the deer can eat naturally from it, and they do. And then in the spring, we chop the stalks, you know, disc and plow it all up, and replant more corn, just for the deer to have food on the hunting property. And then my dad puts in a few acres of sweet corn that he used to pick and sell, but I don't get involved with any of that stuff. We do have a couple of old tractors, old John Deere and Farmall, and like I said, a bunch of old equipment, and that's about it. But when I was a young kid, we did have the dairy farm. A lot of memories from that. There we go. Get back on my row here, and who do we got? We got Tater 18, Jed Stone. Thank you so much for the follow.
Half a semi-trailer right there.
How many semi-trailers have we filled?
We got, I think we're pushing our third one right now.
Wow. Yep. Man, this field takes some time, doesn't it?
Nice big field.
Well, then we hop right across the 15 and do that also, right? Or is it 17?
Yeah, 15's about to go. About to wither. Man, oh man, oh man. Great channel, thank you, Flashbang. F Sim, what's happening? Not working? I'm not ignoring. Sorry. I have the whole family watching this. Say hi to the clan. Well, hello, family. Hello, F Sim Junkie family. Thanks for tuning in. Vikings 12886. We're getting a lot of our regulars in. We're getting a little bit later in the day. The regulars are getting home. Jumping in. Yes, I do hunt in real life. Hunt the whitetail and all kinds of small game that you'll find around Wisconsin here. And I'll be doing my first turkey hunt next month. Next month. Gotta get my turkey deal. Oh, I gotta get that. I gotta set that aside. I gotta get that done today. Oh. Yes, so turkey time. Oh, with the community aspect, definitely. And jump into our community, because you jump into our community and you can get, you can find other players. And we've got a list, we're getting a list of other people that have servers. Right now there's one by, I think it's like Case IH Puma or something like that. It's an individual that comes into our TeamSpeak. They've got a server that they open. It's up to those people to give out the passwords and stuff like that. We don't get into that, but We'll get a list, so, you know, we're trying to get more people to get that list together. I had to try to pay attention to what I was doing there before I drove off. We're getting a little bit of lag from us to the server. But, I'll be able to work through it. There's a lot going on with the server right now, too. Get over here. I gotta watch what I'm doing here. We'll make a mess. Making a mess. I think I might subscribe. Well, we definitely appreciate that very much. How do you get your mod packs? Only mod pack that's available is the one for Pleasant Valley, and that one will be available whenever we open the server. Like yesterday was an open server day. We'll have another one in 2 weeks. Don't know the day yet. So join our Steam group, and you'll be able to get that. Appreciate it. Watching my snowplow video with the JD Moore. Oh my god, that thing is it pushes a lot of snow really for what it is. Last winter was just brutal, but this winter I've only used it like 3 times and I didn't even have to. A couple weeks ago before all of our snow melted and it got up to 70 degrees, the week before that, I think it was 2 to 3 weeks ago, I didn't have to, but I just wanted to. I was like, yeah, I'm going to go clean off the driveway. More than anything, I did it just because I knew the snow was going to melt and I wanted to try to keep the moisture off the driveway. Otherwise, the driveway gets really muddy. So I wanted to push the snow off to the yard. Get the gravel exposed so once it warmed up, it did its thing, and it did. Everything is really dry out. It's dried up a lot. It's so nice. Thank you so much to CRN something or another. Thank you very much for the follow. Oh. All of GunninGamerz mods are personally... Now, there's a bunch of mods there that we don't have permission to give out, so you can find out information pretty much a lot of our recent farm stuff. And but there's a video up I put up a couple weeks ago that talks a little bit about some of that stuff too. That's a 25,000 subscriber video that I did a couple weeks ago, or 2 weeks ago maybe. The last time we got snow. Where's the little, that's Aiden. He doesn't sit in on these videos or on these live streams. He does Wednesdays and Sundays. I don't have him in here too much otherwise. Not good for him to be on the PC that much. We did Minecraft. I actually was in the Minecraft server with him last night and he had a blast. So we're going to try to do some more of that. Plan on running a road from your place to spawn in Minecraft. Is that okay to do? Yeah, if you want to run a road or run a railroad, we're running rail tracks all over in the Minecraft server. If you want to run a road, maybe you want to run a road today and you want to put tracks on it tomorrow, you know. If you did that, you'd probably want to put a fence on both sides just because... Otherwise, you get creepers, all kinds of bad stuff standing on the track, and when you hit them, it's not a good deal. But you can do whatever you want to. just let us know when you get to spawn, and if you plan on doing work, we just don't want people doing work inside of the spawn fence, but you can do whatever you want up to it. That's what it's there for. What are your servers? They're all private. We're just all private. We don't do any public, but we do encourage people to come into our TeamSpeak with their server, and we can let people know about it, and you can get people to jump on and join you and farm, and that's what the community is all about. Being able to link people together that have interests in the same games. Getting full.
Got us. Where?
Oh, you're coming.
Yeah.
Trying not to talk your guys' ear off, so that's why I was muting myself.
Okay. I can keep going.
Alright. Cowboy Roland Cole, welcome back. Oh my goodness, no Plan Evil. Did I just have Plan Evil? I just missed a bunch of stuff here. I was reading chat. Didn't realize it. We'll go get that. That's gonna make or break the server if I leave it. A lot of money.
Sure.
Yep. How much corn did we get out of that now? We up to 300?
Oh yeah, we're over 300 for sure.
Wow.
Once we get to the end here, I'll be able to unload this into the semi and get a final tally of how much we got out of this field.
Final tallies. Now, what's better about this, the auger wagon? Besides that it has beefy tires on it, looks pretty nice with the big tractor.
The biggest benefit is when you go to unload into the semi.
It has a higher pipe.
The pipe is longer, so it reaches out better. You don't have to get so close to the semi and everything.
Alright. Chey, thank you so much for the follow. Jedstone, everybody, thanks for them follows.
Or not.
Cruising.
Yeah, there's 192,000 in the semi right now.
And you've already dumped a 300?
I've already dumped 140.
Wow.
192. This should put it over, because I got 14 right now. So yeah, well, I have about 303,000 liters out of this field, same as what I got the last time.
I'm gonna work on something different. Take a break from the harvesting, because we've been doing that for over an hour. I know we're gonna lose that field, but we'll have to knock it out somehow.
I'll start knocking it out.
Okay. Get in a forky, new forky. Wow, for the spacing on the. Love that forklift. I'll go and drop this on the trailer.
349,000 liters.
349,000. Wow. That's pretty awesome. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Yeah, actually I am getting really laggy like a bugger here. It's pretty bad all of a sudden. Really bad.
I've had a couple of lag spikes here lately.
Alright. What else we got going on here? Silage in the pits. Oh, this is our neat little this conveyor is so slick. It hooks up to the back so you can dump right out the back of the semi. And you know, like we're Husky, you must have put manure in the trailer. We're selling manure.
Yep.
And the same thing goes for greenhouses.
Have you been able to get it to conveyor to dump in the greenhouses?
I haven't tried it, have you?
No, I tried it and it didn't work. I used it.
It should.
I haul the manure over there, but it dumps into the wheel loader bucket.
So it won't
run into wheel loader back for
it. So it won't. That's what we were gonna try. So it, even if you lower the conveyor, it still won't trigger to dump into the greenhouse.
Yeah, I don't know what sort of trigger it is.
But it won't. But it won't. But you did try to lower it, right?
Yep, I had it sitting right up on top though.
Okay. Well, that just answers a question that Lee and I were wondering. Boy, is it laggy all of a sudden. Oh my god, I don't know what's going on here.
I just bring it over there, you know, with the trailer full of the manure.
Yeah.
And the conveyor, and then just you can empty the conveyor with trigger on the wheel loader bucket.
Right. Yeah, it's a lot of work though for what it is. Works good though for other stuff. I'm not gonna fart around with it today. It'll take me more time to get it set up than probably just to go ahead and get the job done.
I'm coming early.
Oh, go look at all of our beautiful greenhouses that we've got. What's my Steam name? It's GunninGamerz on the Steam. Oh, you're talking about somebody else? Yeah, join our GunninGamerz on Steam. It's a great place to link up with other players. These are all our greenhouses. There's 10 of them in each row. There's 20 of them. That's why when I edited the map, I did it just like this. Now, as far as mixing stations go, we just popped that one down, but with the placeable helper mod, look how close we got them all in there. Look how nice that looks. All 10 of them. We got room for another 10, so we could have 30 greenhouses total if we wanted to. And then we have all the mixing stations that can go in there too. But we're not really to that point, and we kind of want to run. What we're running one mixing station, we only got a few hundred cattle. We'll probably end up getting this farm up to like 3,000 to 5,000 cattle at one point, just like we did with our 2013. Just like 2013. There we go. Yeah, we really burn up a lot more manure now. Ah!
Still not enough to keep up with cows.
Yeah. It's not enough to... Oh, we're not burning up enough. We got more cows than what we can... Wow. Yeah. This is... Oh... My dear God, are you guys getting lagged like atrocious?
Not right now.
Nah, it's just on my end then. It's really gotten bad. Not good. Boy, I need to get started earlier. I need to start by like noon. I got started at 1:30 today, and it's you get up to about 5 o'clock, which it is here. Start running into big time. Starts to slow down quite a bit. They do look good though, those line of greenhouses, don't they?
Oh yeah.
You busted it at work today? Well, at least you can feel good about that. Putting in a hard day. Turn up for Friday night. That's a lot of greenhouses. We're gonna have to see how much more we can go. I'm gonna work on some of these greenhouses, but I'd like to get a few other jobs thrown in here. We gotta get... I think... Come on. I think we need to haul some silage off, so I'll have to get our semi over here for that. Hey YouTube, if it's on YouTube. Saying hello to all the future viewers. Yeah, this'll go on YouTube. And we did include the chat on the screen today. Last week I didn't. Don't know if we're always going to be, but did today. Started it out, didn't think about it, and thought, oh, let's just leave it. Hey, Bling Dude, what's going on? Knight Rider. Hi, YouTube. Everybody's saying hi to YouTube. Oh, I had a little bit more in there. Oh, dang it. Should we dump it? Should we not dump it? Oh my goodness. Damn, that's a lot of greenhouses. Takes a lot to keep this farm going, and we don't have a lot of players on at the moment, because the Pleasant Valley's been taking up a lot of the resources. But we'll be going in periods on this farm where we hit it hard and then we, you know, take our foot off the gas a little bit. But that's where all the machines will come in handy, all the mixing stations. And we did 5,000 cows in 13. I want to see what we're able to accomplish in this one. But definitely, if any of you folks have the crew, the good old crew, if you've got the crew, I want to try to do a community, get the crew together in the community tonight. So if you've got the crew, let's get it on. Let's get in there. And I think I'm going to send out an announcement on Steam. I think I'm going to go in there regardless, because I haven't played in several days. And we're just going to have some fun driving around, leveling up cars. And, I don't know, Lee was playing a lot last night. I'm thinking he might be there. He usually does jump into the crew. He might not. He might be busy. But a bunch of the guys will get the crew and we get in and just have a good old hootin' nanny. So if you have the crew, come on by the TeamSpeak tonight. We'll be in the channel. It is an adult-only channel, but the youngsters are welcome. They'll just be in the other channels. I know as for me, I'm going to be cracking a cold one open and just letting my hair down and just relaxing and doing some driving and jamming. Maybe I'll have some music on my end. You'll have to play your own music, get some music going, and just freaking tear it up. Go fast. We'll check out each other's cars. You've seen a lot of my cars. I'll show you mine if you show me yours. You know, it's a good time. So, I'm looking forward. I love it. I love getting in and playing the crew, but I can't find people! Everybody's like, I want to play. Well, get your ass in here and let's do it then. Oh my goodness. A lot of people are all talking, no game. Literally no game. Let's not talk about it. Let's do it. I'll be there. And then I'll be in the Minecrafts tonight. Freaking Friday night. Let's do some gaming. Holy crap. Our Minecraft server's a little bit locked up, you know? It's not a public. Holy crapper, I can't even imagine. We'd be getting really trolled up in there. But, always things, if I had more time. If I had more time, it'd be really cool to have a public server, but I know it would get trashed. It would be kind of neat. It would be kind of neat, I will admit, but I don't even fathom it, because I'd never have the time. I struggle to get into that. You know, you can only do so much games. It really is the way it goes. We're fighting through our little laggies time. Just to fling poop. Let's do this! Yes! Holy greenhouses! Yes! Did you get your vet yet in the crew? Oh yeah, hey Stale Popcorn. Yes, definitely. We got the vet in the crew. We got three of them. Three of them got the old ones. Old ones, I mean, they're okay. They're okay. Not as impressed as I wanted to be. They don't sound nice like the Camaro, but they're nice. They're nice. Yeah, so They're good. Holy lag, Batman. We're almost done. We're almost done with the poopies. Then we're gonna go and do water, and that'll be all kind of fun. Holy crappers. A lot of greenhouses. Another view of the greenhouses and the beautiful placeable helper mod. Let me go ahead and put them in here like you see them. I love it. And when I did this edit, this is exactly what I had in mind. We've got two rows. We can get a third row and still have a whole row of greenhouses. Mixing stations. The mixing station was just plopped in there. It was not, we didn't use the thing. We just threw it in there. Eventually we'll delete that and we'll get that straight and we'll a whole line of those as well. It takes one mixing station per 500 cattle or two per 1,000. So 5,000 means we'll need 10. So we'll probably be popping 10 of them in. And that'll be a good time. I'll probably end up popping 10 of them in here even before we need them. We'll just not use all of them. Just because when you're doing those placeables, it's easier to do them all at once. And the same thing with Bjornholm. I'm going to save up our money until we can put... We're not going to be able to fit this many. I wouldn't want this many, but I do want to be able to get, like... I'm thinking 12, like 6 and 6, or 14 maybe, and pop all them in a row. Well, Giants, to make a Freightliner big rig. Why don't you tell them? I'll tell them. I'll send them a mail in the snail mail. It'll take 3 weeks to get to Germany. Or I think they're in Deutschland. I'm not sure. I forget. I know SCS, which does Euro Truck, is in Czechoslovakia. Giants, I think it's in Germany. You should get the tipping mod and a trailer. We kind of have that, but it's just too much to fart around with all that right now. We don't have the one you're talking about. We've got the conveyor and, you know, all that sort of thing. But this is honestly not that bad. Actually, wouldn't be bad at all if I didn't have a little bit of lag spike. Yeah, that was a little bit bad. That was swinging me around there. Think about how much that glass would be busted out if it was real. I don't know. You wouldn't want to have so much glass in a manure deal right there. But yeah, we're gonna get something to do with the manure. More on the manure side of things. We will be adding something in. We've got the conveyor. I think I'm only going to have to go back for about two more scoops of poop. Let's go ahead and dump some scheiss into this one. There you go. Got a play to be in. Interesting. Kentucky or Wisconsin gonna win. Oh my god, what's going on? Just curiosity here, but did you... Holy frick! Like 10 people just sent things that I'm trying to read. Did you... That Space Engineers has a multiplayer? Yeah, I knew it had a multiplayer. I just don't have time to dive into it. I bought it over a year ago and didn't, it wasn't very good because it wasn't very done. Now I know they've added a lot in, but I don't know anybody that has it besides myself. Evil and I have looked at it recently, a few months back on Twitch, to watch a guy play to see all the changes. It's sometimes easier for me to do that than actually go in and try to play it myself. And this Dingleberry, I watched him about 3 or 4 nights in a row. He sat in a freaking, like, a crafting kind of a menu, not actually playing the game the whole time. And he was, like, the most boring individual I've ever seen in my life. I wanted to off myself sitting there watch that, so I pretty much was like, okay. I don't know where this game is at, but I don't want to be sitting in the menu that he's sitting in. Holy crap. But, I've seen a couple YouTube vids, and it does look like it's getting pretty fun, pretty good. So, I have to probably check it out again one of these days, re-download it on my system, and and jump in, because it would be... That does look like that game would be a good bit of fun. Reign of Kings is another one that I'm gonna want to dive into. Just a lot of different games that we want to get busting loose on. Tell Giants to make a Pete 379 and 39 beta. Giants won't ever make anything. I think you could tell Giants until your lips and ears turn blue, and they're not. They don't make a lot of different equipment, I guess. Kind of make what's in the game, and I think it'd be kind of nice if they spit DLC packs out left and right. I'd buy them all. As long as they're good equipment. Well, that's a heavy load of poop. Poopies. Do I play any MMO? Nah, at the moment. Not at the moment. I was last year. I was in a couple more MMO FPS. But no, haven't been. We're going to be taking a break from no live streams next week. And I'm going to be kind of redoing a bunch of things on the old, as far as the games and the gameplays that we do. A lot of things are going to probably be changing with the live streams. I think we're going to focus a little bit more on farming on Friday afternoon and a lot less farming the rest of the time. So people that are big fans of the farm, and they're going to have to jump on. And if they don't, if they're not able to, you'll be able to catch it on YouTube. We kind of want to be able to include all of our Euro fans on being able to watch the farms, see all the things that are happening, and we want to focus a lot more on other games, with the exception of Sunday night. I think Sunday night we're going to keep doing our farming. It seems like it's a pretty big thing on Sunday night. I think that's when we're probably going to be doing our farming. I think I'm going to take farming off of the Wednesday rotation as well. I want to put some thought into it, though. I think Friday, Westbridge, Pleasant Valley, and then dive into go over here. Whoa! And then we're going to dive into Bjornholm on Sunday. I think that'll be, you know, probably 2 hours of Westbridge, 2 hours of Pleasant Valley on Friday for a total of 4 hours, and then we'll probably do Sunday night 3 to 4 hours, no more than four, probably 3 hours on Sunday. Half of Sunday's 6 hour stream. I can't remember if I filled this one up all the way. Yeah, and then we're gonna focus on other games. Wednesdays and Saturdays we already do. We don't do as much of the farming side. But the good thing is there'll be 4 hours of farming every week put up on YouTube for people that miss the Friday stream. So that'll be, I think, a big hit. There's a lot of poo-poo. Imagine the stench over there. Tanky Online, what is that? Tanks Online? World of Tanks? I did the World of Planes. I never did play World of Tanks, so. Now we get to go do water. Oh, that sounds good, F-Sim. Yeah, I gotta catch a few things going on in the Space Engineers world. I'd like to see, because, like I said, I bought that over a year ago. I think it was right about March, maybe February last year or something. It was when it first came available on Steam. I dove into the early... I got a lot of games that I bought early access and just honestly have walked away from because they just need to get done a little bit more. I mean, Stranded Deep, once I find that carburetor, I'm walking away from that. Get that boat built. There's nothing, I mean, they need to get, you know, let them get the game finished, and then we'll come back for more. I've got about 20 early access games, The Forest, I mean, the list could go on and on of all these early access games that I played them. I did them. They need. I want them to get the game finished. Whoops. Oh yeah, it is. I get these sheds confused. Okay, slideshow. Apologize. Yeah, it's really gotten laggy. Next Friday, I won't be doing one of these, but the Friday after, I'm going to be starting by noon. I want to be done by 4 o'clock because we've got very broken internet in my area. It started on, oh god, broken record, but January 22nd, they cobbled our internet up over here, and it's been this massive company project of millions of dollars of infrastructure needed to fix everything. Everything got broken, and so this project started March 9th, Monday of last week, and it's supposed to finish up April 1st, and I can tell you right now our internet is not improved. And it's kind of disheartening in a way because my income relies on it, so that's motivated us to basically realize that the only way to get better internet is to move. And we were going to move next year anyway, but we've kind of pushed that up a year. See where we're at. We've got 100,000 on the water. You gotta get really close. That's the one thing I don't like about these greenhouses. Okay, if we hit 3 at 2 miles an hour. I think he just filled these. Nope. Seriously? Why you gotta get so straight on. And you gotta be like rubbing the cement with your tires. They really should have extended the triggers on these greenhouses. I have to blast Giants on that a little bit. Okay, it's at 100. My bad. And then you run into the thing, and then your truck won't move, and it's just... Sure, they all hit 100. Just like that. All of them hitting 100. This is an easy job. This is an easy job. What version of Westbridge is this? The GunninGamerz edition. This is my edit on Westbridge. Took the vanilla Westbridge and made my edits to it. Got a nice little dirt racetrack with jumps and everything on it too. It's a good bit of fun with the pickup trucks. I just haven't done any racing. We'll have to get together a race on here. I'm gonna do a race one of these days. Get everybody, all of our members back in, and we'll have a big race. And I'm gonna give away a game or something as part of that to whoever the winner of. We'll do, like, a series. Whoever the winner of the series is. Probably throw them, like, a $30 game or something. I won't be in the race, especially if I got a little bit of lag or something. I'll be the referee. I'll fly above the action, and we'll look at everything from up above, and we'll watch all of them race. It'll be a good bit of fun. We got all kinds of different games we can do. Hauling pallets, and having pallets flying out, and everything else. And all these things can make us a little bit more money. This is always important. Takes them a while to pay for themselves, so they're about half full on water, so it's good to top them off. Farming Sim 13. Boy, I'd take that over to the community, Vikings, and ask over there. Find out if Uh-oh, what happened here? That was weird. Huh? It won't fill up. Weird. That is really weird. I've never seen that before. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. We're coming up to 2 hours. We gotta get off of here. Otherwise, it won't fit on YouTube. Thank you so much to JN, Chase. Thank you also for that follow earlier. Definitely appreciate those. If you're interested in getting some cool emoticons, you get a couple tractors, and some other stuff. Hit that subscribe button down below. We're going to do a subscriber-only open farming on our Pleasant Valley server next week. Sounds like it'll be Thursday night through Saturday evening. Thursday evening through Saturday evening. It'll be basically 2 days, 48 hours. So, and that's that. Now, I could go to the pond and fill this for free, but water is very hard to come by. I wonder if we put the hose out. Oh, it comes out the other side. I hate the water triggers on these objects. I kind of miss our placeable pipe. I have to put that back in. I'll have placeable pipes at the end of the rows there, so when you get to the end, you just fill up. Now we're filling her up. Put some water back in it. How hot is it? Oh, it's not that hot at all. It's fairly cool today. I think it's 49 degrees. Not too hot. Well, guys, I'm going to be jumping off here in a minute. Thank you for helping. We're coming up to the hours here.
Okay.
Yep.
Sorry, I had myself muted. I was ranting and talking and didn't want to talk your ears off, so...
That's fine.
No problem.
I got the greenhouses all done. You guys are hammering on that field still?
Yep.
Greenhouses are full of manure, water, and we're about to hit the 2-hour mark, so I'm going to jump off and I will catch up with all of you guys very shortly.
Okay, talk to you later.
All right.
Yep.
All righty. Whoa. I'm going to park this up here because I think we're really coming right up to that 2-hour mark. 2 hours is a maximum. You can bring over from Twitch to YouTube without splitting it into parts, and I don't want to have like part one and part two. We don't want to do that. I want to get plus two hours in a video. That's a lot of time for, you know, that's like longer than most Hollywood movies. That's not a good way to put the trailer. This trailer is a bear to handle though when you get it full of water. We've been parking it over here, and I'm not a big fan because I don't like cutting through these trees. Of course, we could back that in, but I'm going to leave that truck sitting right there. Probably have to go give some food and water to the cows later anyway, so that's going to be that for this update number 2. It'll be all on YouTube if you miss some. Pleasant Valley, we did about an hour and 40 minutes or so, hour and a half. That'll be on YouTube also if you miss that. It'll be on there probably by the time I stream tomorrow. So I'll be back on the live stream tomorrow, no later than 10 p.m. I plan to be there about 8:30. Again, we'll start a little bit early. I want to thank everybody that took time out of their day to come out today. We'll definitely give a save right there. And we're going to hop out. I definitely appreciate everybody that, again, took time out of their day to come out and watch. Looks like we'll be taking spring break, kind of a break next week, so there won't be any live streams. But we'll be back on this weekend, at least Saturday. I haven't decided on Sunday stream yet. So We'll just see what happens. We'll see what happens on Saturday night. But don't forget